Nicholas. You'll be familiar with her story. She alleged she was raped by top cops, forcing multiple inquiries and eventually changed police culture for the better.
Her story has now been turned into a movie, and yesterday the Justice Minister, senior police officers and Louise watched the final cut, and Jahan Casanada was there.
Louise is someone you either choose to believe or not.
Don't you believe me?
It's not what I believe. It's what a jury believes.
And I think the New Zealand public judge her really harshly.
I was told I was nothing but an educated, vindictive, sex-crazed, racist, media-loving liar.
She lets it all brush off her. She doesn't take it personally. For that to happen, you either have to be a politician or you actually have to be a person with incredible inner honesty and truth.
Her story was kept secret for years.
One individual's relentless pursuit of justice.
Now every sordid, scandalous detail is about to play out on screen.
It took a wee bit to sink in about how they were going to do it. I think that was our worry. They wanted to honour the truth, my truth, and they nailed it.
It covers 25 years of her life from a small New Zealand town, Wairarapa.
Louise alleged she was raped by a policeman at just 13, her vivid memories now brought to life by actors.
It was a bit mentally hard and emotional because I had to cry a lot. I think she's quite amazing. She's got a lot of courage.
Louise also alleged in her late teens she was gang raped by three policemen.
It absolutely took me back, and I recalled every little detail.
You say you were sexually assaulted by a number of these officers.
She pressed charges, and all of the cops accused were acquitted.
I was all good up until the scene where Ross and I are sitting at the table.
I guess I need you to know one of my biggest secrets.
That was my kick in the guts, and I lost it.
Louise went public with her story a decade ago.
And police forces in for a major shake.
It sent shockwaves through the police force.
It actually made me look at it differently.
Louise's story is a controversial one. The jury never knew that two of the accused were already in jail for rape. And a top inspector was found guilty of perverting the course of justice to protect his mates.
At the end of the day, the audience will have to make up their own mind.
The Justice Minister was one of the first to see the movie.
The fact that you've got senior police officers choosing to be here and deeply moved by it is a great testament to Louise.
And even our top cop is keen to have Louise on his team.
Now, working with Louise over the years and understanding her journey has really helped inform the way we police now.
Louise gave her blessing to the movie, hoping it'll encourage other victims of abuse to come forward.
I have such a different respect for Mum.
Is it humbling?
Yeah, very humbling. I'm at a point in my life now where I know that I can't be hurt anymore. I feel I've dealt with it. There's nothing more I can do with it except bring the positives from it.
All right, regardless of how you feel about Louise Nicholas or the new movie telling her harrowing story, surely we can all agree that this movie is a good thing for those that have been victims of sexual assault, to know that it's okay to speak out no matter what the situation or how hard it might seem. Just today I was reading about how victims are less likely to come forward now in India because the attackers are now using smartphones to record assaults, then use the footage to threaten their victims with exposure. As technology improves, exploitation becomes easier. Sexual assault isn't going away, and the more we can expose it, I say the better.